Now at 5, Seattle's Harborview Medical Center on the short list to take in patients infected with Ebola. Cairo 7 takes you inside the testing lab and tells you how patients would be isolated to keep the virus from spreading.
That announcement that we streamed on CairoTV.com drew an incredible response from people worried about bringing the deadly virus to Western Washington.
Among the biggest questions, why us and how can doctors guarantee our safety?
Cairo 7's Essex Porter is live right now at Harborview with those answers. Essex? What you are watching is a training exercise for a worst-case scenario involving oil trains that run through Seattle. Cairo 7 asked for access so we could show you the dangers and the way Seattle firefighters would respond. For months, we have been asking about everything from tunnel safety to the speed of oil trains.
And now our Graham Johnson shows us how people on the front lines prepare for a disaster.
Now at 5:30. The city of Seattle will change the name of Columbus Day. Tonight, Cairo 7 talks to both sides.
In my heart, I was just flying and soaring like the eagle.
Including some who say this is a huge waste of time.
Italian Americans call it a slap in the face of their heritage.
Native Americans say it was the name change to Indigenous Peoples Day that was long overdue.
New at 5:30, Cairo 7's Deborah Horn is live in Seattle. And Deborah, they really can't do away with Columbus Day, right? We finally know what the Seattle Police Department is doing about the $1 million in wasted overtime we told you about last week. Cairo 7's Henry Rossoff was at a city council meeting where the chief faced some tough questions about how the overtime happened. Henry.
At first,
the door opened, this guy jumped in and just started punching me and started yelling, "I'm going to kill you." And
Cairo 7 talks to this driver minutes after a man tried to steal his car and held a knife to his throat. Our Gary Horker is live in Seattle where this went down. Gary.
See you again soon, Gary. And now to a story we broke into programming to tell you about at 3 o'clock.
Essex Porter is live at Gatewood Elementary in West Seattle where a student confronted a teacher with a knife. Essex. Now to the Ebola crisis and new screening measures going into place at 5 major U.S. airports.
SeaTac is not on that short list. We are still working to find out why some smaller preventative measures are not in place here.
Our live team coverage includes the latest from Dallas and what we found when we asked local walk-in clinics how they were dealing with the fears about Ebola.
But we start with Cairo 7's Henry Rossoff. He's live at SeaTac right now. Henry. Is relief on Mercer Island tonight where a boil water alert has finally ended. But since Cairo 7 broke that news at noon, we've been trying to get answers about what caused the E. coli contamination in the first place. And Graham Johnson is live right now on the island where restaurants are now fully reopening again. Graham.
Now at 5:30, Mariners merchandise stolen by a Safeco cleaning crew. Cairo 7 wanted to know how they got hired and found out not only could just about anyone get the job, but the team never did a background check.
Our Joanna Small spent hours peeling back red tape to find out who hired those suspects and why the Mariners would trust them in the same places they allow fans.
And she asked police how you could tell if you're wearing one of the stolen jerseys.
Victory tonight for Seattle elementary school parents who had to raise $90,000 in a week to keep a beloved teacher. Cairo 7's Essex Porter is live at Gatewood Elementary with what was an emotional outcome, Essex.
Right now, we're asking if Mercer Island water customers will get a break on their water bills due to a boil water advisory that lasted now 6 days. Cairo 7's Graham Johnson is live on the island. And Graham, since that advisory ended at noon, you've been looking into what happens next.
Now at 5, these two men sentenced for an attempted thrill kill.
This was pleasure in killing and hurting somebody. They do not need to be in our society.
One admitted he hacked at the victim's leg to keep him from escaping. The other says he enjoyed attacking the teen.
The disturbing descriptions of the crime do not end there. One of the men said he felt as if he were in a video game the night he tortured his victim.
And both admitted that they broke into a complete stranger's home bent on killing. New at 5 o'clock, Cairo 7's Amy Clancy was in that courtroom when the judge threw the book at them.